好，接下来看一个船难的新闻，有一艘参观铁达尼号残骸的观光潜水艇，在加拿大纽芬兰的外海下潜1小时45分钟之后完全失踪，现在出动了美国海岸防卫队开始搜救。潜水艇上有5个人，包括驾驶跟3名乘客，以及1名铁达尼号的专家，而英国亿万富翁哈丁也在上面。搜救是要跟时间赛跑，因为舱内的氧气预计还可以再维持96小时，也就是只剩4天的时间。潜水艇失踪的原因排除了天候因素，目前研判可能是一个海流影响导致潜水艇故障无法升上水面。
一艘专门潜入海底参观铁达尼号残骸的观光潜水艇，周日早上在加拿大纽芬兰外海370海里处失踪。潜水艇在下潜1小时45分钟之后，与海面上的监控船失联。美国海岸防卫队接获通报，出动搜索。
The location of the search is approximately 900 miles east of Cape Cod, in a water depth of roughly 13,000 feet.It is a remote area, and it is a challenge to conduct a search in that remote area.
铁达尼号潜水艇旅游公司海洋之门的官网显示，失踪潜水艇的长度为6.7公尺，搭载5名乘客时，舱内氧气可维持96个小时，约4天的时间。
It is a race against time. You're fighting oxygen levels. They should have a day or two more left of oxygen.Also fighting the cold, if the sub is still in the bottom, because the deep ocean is just above freezing cold, so hypothermia is an issue. I think one of the biggest things, where is it? Is it on the bottom? Is it floating? Is it midwater?And that's something that hasn't been determined yet.
美国海巡卫队派出船只和多架飞机在海面上搜索，加拿大也派出巡逻机加入，并在海上设置声呐浮标探测海底的动静，并留意潜水艇可能发出的求救信号。
Any of the normal pieces that a unit like this submersible should have, a releasable beacon that would have gone to the surface and could have been sending out a signal.
潜水艇失踪当天气候状况良好，因此可排除气候因素。另一个可能是潜水艇受到海流影响，发生机械故障，因此无法上升到水面。
It could be entrapped. It's very easy for it to suddenly get caught on something and it can't come back to the surface.
潜水艇上共有5人，包括1名驾驶和3名乘客及1名铁达尼号的专家。英国亿万富豪哈丁也在上面，他是国际飞机经纪公司的董事长，同时也是一位探险家，过去曾前往太空。另一名乘客是铁达尼号旅游公司的创办人兼 CEO 罗素。一位研究铁达尼号的历史学家也曾经参加过相同的行程，他认为5人的存活机会很大。
Deep submersible diving is very dangerous, but it is, it's high tech, you know, and as each year goes by, the equipment gets better, the technology gets better, and so on. So, I'm very hopeful and very positive. I mean, I was in the sub for 12 hours. We have our own breathing system on board, and if that's maintained properly, like changing your filter and your CO2 scrubber, you can stay down there for, you know, quite a few hours. And in our case, you know, I was down there for 12 hours total time in the sub.And the new technology obviously can extend that too, right?
救援专家也认为，这次的事件与法国和马来西亚航空坠海失踪那种大海捞针的搜救状况不同。潜水艇有明确下潜位置，可以缩小搜寻范围。
It's very different from something like Air France or Malaysian Air in that the surface ship should have a pretty good idea where the sub was last known, its last known position.A sub won't go very far. It might, if it's got into trouble on the surface, it may drift a bit. But on the bottom, motoring 2 miles an hour, something like that. So the search area should be small. That doesn't mean it'll be easy to find, but it means that you can focus on a very tight area and bring your sonars in and cameras in and whatever you need to do.Into that area to try to locate.
一旦发现潜水艇的踪迹，搜救人员会先派无人潜水艇勘察状况，然后将潜水艇打捞到海面，才能开舱门救人。铁达尼号游轮在1912年撞上冰山沉没，超过1500人罹难。1985年残骸被发现，船身断成了2节。近期研究人员利用深海地图绘制的科技，呈现出铁达尼号在海底的图像，也让它 成为热门的海底旅游景点，只不过价格十分的高昂，一个人的旅费要25万美金，约合台币750万。 TVBS 新闻综合报道。
想看最完整的新闻内容，记得下载 TVBS 新闻网 APP。